Hello. So it's the middle of September now. I haven't been out for about a month, I'd say. I've been busy in the house working, getting plastering done and getting like fittings put in and stuff like that. But that's all done now, and I thought, treat myself, two nights fishing. And I had a look back last year, because I haven't been fishing for like a couple of weeks. I started watching some of my old video blogs. And last year, one of my favourite sessions, even though I had a pretty awesome year last year, one of my favourite sessions was the two nights at Springwater Lakes. So I got in the car, took the, I think it's about an hour and a half drive it took me. I got stuck in a camper van, which added it another sort of like 20 minutes to the journey. But yeah, so I'm here at Springwater Lakes. And hopefully I'm going to get a bit of a repeat of last year. Last year I had 17 fish in something like 36 or 40 hours or something like that. And I had new PB common, so anything like that is going to be like amazing. So yeah, it's been raining since I got here. Literally, as I arrived, it started drizzling. As I started bringing the stuff around, it absolutely lashed down. The bivvy was soaking when I was putting it up. It's taken me about 3 hours to get everything ready and get rods out. But yeah, I got my rods out. I'm fishing the Mistral fruit bomb boilies at the moment. I just sprinkled a whole, well, they're only small bags, they're like 300 gram bags, so I sprinkled a whole 300 gram bag out over two spots, and just single bottom baits with a little bit of cork popping them up, or just lifting them off the bottom. But yeah, enough of that. Yeah, so I'll see you later. Hopefully I'll get a few fish before it gets dark, because I think we got about four hours of light left. So hopefully we'll get a few fish, and then we'll get a few more in the night and tomorrow. All right, then I'll catch you later. Go. First fish of the session taken on our fruit bomb, like a red one, 9.3. It's quite a nice, it's almost like leather sort of flanks on it, but it's a nice little mirror, nice little way to start the day, 9.3, or start the session anyway. Right, I'm not going to keep her out too long because she's been going mad on the bank. Let's get her back. Right then, so this is fish number two. Ooh. Yeah, so it's coming up at 7 pounds exactly. Not sure, I know last year I had a fish with one eye, and I've just had another one with no eye. I don't know if it's the same fish, but this was bang on 7 pounds, so I'll have a look at last year's pictures, and I'll see if it's the same fish. So, I'll show you this. See, it's only got one eye. I don't know if you can see that properly, actually. But, yeah. Right, let's get it back. Right then, so I'm, what, two fish in now? It's coming up to 9 o'clock. Bugs flying around here, brilliant. Yeah, it's, the rain's recommenced. It's absolutely hammering down outside now at the moment. All I've done, I've quickly scurried out, thrown out about a kilo and a half of bait over three spots, cast out on all three of them and just left it. Hopefully I get running when the rain stops. But yeah, this is it for now, I think. I do feel like I'm going to get a few runs during the night, but I'll have to wait and see. Alright then, if all else fails, I'll see you in the morning. Ta-da. Just gone 10:30. got a common that's worth catching now. 11.2 it was. What it is. Let's get him up. Tell you what, this one absolutely fought like stink. Just kept running. It's unbelievable, but look at, you can tell by the paddle it's got. It tussled with the weeds quite a lot. But, yeah, it's hammering down with rain now. We really don't want to be doing this in the rain. Yeah, so, three fish. And I've got a double now, anyway. Right, let's get a quick photo and I'll get him back.
Right then, I've just hooked and landed something I was chasing earlier on this year, and it's in the net. Can you see that? Ooh. It's a grass. It's quite a big one and he's not very happy. Right then, I've just weighed him. He's coming in at 19.7 pounds. But it's well, look at the size on it. It's just, look at that compared to my hand. I'm gonna recheck the scales, I think. I don't know, I'd have thought it had gone 20, 22, something like that, just by picking it up, but 19 pounds, I'm still. Still over the moon. Look at the size of this thing. It's an absolute leviathan. But
I've already showed you in the net and in the sling. What was it 19.7 pounds? It's, I think I might have to move back. It's so long. It's not going to fit on the screen. But here we go. Down. It's taking on a fruit bomb. A proper bomb. Look at that. And that tail, it's like bigger than my hand. But it's kicked off a few times and it's not happy. Oh, would have been lovely to have one of these in the sun instead of a rainy night. But let's give him a quick. Let's get him round. I bought myself a new sling and it's bigger than the old one and this fish is the same size as it. But here we go. It's supposed to be a 30 pound grass carp in here. Imagine how big that one's going to be. But this is 19 pound. You chuck another 10 pound on that. What's it going to be, fatter or 2 foot longer? I don't know. But, right, let's get it back. It's had it out long enough. Right. Right then. Yeah, that was pretty awesome fish, actually, wasn't it? But. I don't know if it's like you feel like you have to get the right weight. I've just double checked everything and I was overweighing the sling by 1 pound and 4 ounces. I double checked and double checked again. I soaked it, shook it off, double checked again. It was 1 pound 4. There's no way I could have been holding 1 pound and 4 ounces of water in the sling, mainly because it's a mesh sling and it doesn't actually hold any water. So it gives it, what's that one? Can't work it out. It's 20 pounds 11 is the weight that it should have been coming up as. I know that I quickly I slammed it round in, because it's hammering down. I slammed it round. I reset the scales and then put them on, and I don't know, but it was weighing. I know that the wet sling, it was coming up as just over 5 pound, and I know that it's 3 pound something when it's wet, and I don't know why I just didn't double check it then, but so it's 20. I don't know if that's I don't know. It doesn't make any difference, does it really? It's still an awesome fish. Right. I'm gonna bait that rod back up and put it back on the same spot. See if I can't. It'd be nice if I could get a 20-pound common and a 20-pound mirror then to round it off. But we'll see. We'll see. I've still got two nights left. This one hasn't finished yet. Right then. Ta-da. Right then. It's 2 a.m. Just had another screaming run, went straight into the weeds again. It's blowing me away. It's 21 pound 6 ounce common carp. And again, it's like every fish in here. Scrapped like hell. Look at that. That is a huge common carp. It's another PB for me, another PB common. PB grass carp. Perhaps fishing in the rain isn't that bad after all. Right, let's get him round, have a look at the other side. Ooh. Actually, I haven't actually been asleep yet. I haven't had any sleep at all. But again, to pull back a bit. Something I'm not fully in the screen, am I? Look at that. Solid chunk of a common. It's fantastic. Well, two 20 pound fish in a matter of 2 hours. I didn't think that would ever happen.
Here we go. It's a new PB common carp for me. Got a piece missing from his tail, so if anybody does catch it again, they'll know that, well, the people will say what it was. It's a 21 pound 6. Ooh, it's getting covered. Right. Then, let's say farewell to the second half of my brace of 20s. And there she goes.
Right, and good morning. It's now 10 o'clock. I've been sleeping up until now. I'm absolutely knackered after last night. And then, well, I got woke up by this little comet. Oh, 9 pounds, 8 ounces. It's a cracking little fish, isn't it? It's half pound short of a double. Fought well, like a fish well into its doubles. So, I'm not quite awake, and this thing give me the run around properly. Oh, so, what's that? Fish number 6, I think it is. It's not bad, is it? 220s. I'd have never thought it. Right, let's get it back. Last time I switched the camera on was like 10 o'clock, it's now 1 o'clock. I did try a bit of surface fishing over on the side there where the lilies are. I hooked into one and it powered off into the lilies and eventually spat the hook. So I think I wrecked the whole patch of lilies then because nothing is there since. But it's starting to rain again now, so I've huddled underneath the brawley. I got the rod, I've had a single knock on the right hand rod running into the running right next to the lilies again actually. But it's been a mixed bag. Usually I don't know what it is when I fish this lake that I put the rods out in sort of like different spots and one will produce and the rest won't. Literally. The grass cap came from the left hand margin where I've got that rod. My first mirror came from, I can't see, the little gap in there, and the 21 came off the one down in the side, so all three rods are doing their job. I was trying to think of ways that I could better this session. I know that probably banking another 10 carp or something like that would cream it off, and then I started thinking there is 30s in this lake. There was a 30-pound, mid-30s grass cap put in here, but there is a 32-pound or 33-pound common in here, and a 34 or 35-pound mirror. Well, you don't know the weights until you get them out again, really, do you? But so there's plenty of reason to stay on. Right then, so I've had to change over baits because the fruit bomb, they're only in sort of like half kilo bags and I've gone through all of them. I did have enough just for hook baits, but I thought it's pointless if they're not looking for them. So what I've done, I've changed over, I've gone to the coconut krill, got them there, they're there. And I've used them on here before, and I was on here for a quick 24-hour session, probably a bit less than that, and I end up with 7 fish. So in numbers, this is more successful than the fruit bomb. The size, I think fruit bomb wins hands down, really. But what I'm doing now, I'm taking a load of them out and just drilling them. Because I got the rigs I've got set. I've got like one of them's got a little tiny piece of cork running through it, and the other one's slightly bigger. So I'm just drilling about 4 or 5 of each. That's sort of like, I don't know if you probably can't even see that in there. That's sort of like a 5mm depth, and then I'm doing one at about an 8mm depth. So that if I need to change the bait, sort of like when it starts getting dark, I'm not sitting here with the drill grinding it out. They're already done. But yeah. Alright then, I'll catch you later. That was a hairy fight. You dug yourself straight into the lilies and literally locked me up. But I changed angle about 20 times and eventually it quite free. Knackered now. Looks like a nice double though. There you go. 12.10 pounds. Fought like something a lot bigger again. It actually looks, if you look, I don't know if you can make that out. But it's, for a fish's size, it's really wide. But, yeah, I thought I might have killed the spot. Because I swapped over baits, had gone from the fruit bomb, and I'd loaded it literally about 6 or 7 big handfuls of the coconut krill. And I had a knock on it for 3 hours, and then, bang, this little beauty turns up. Here's the other side. A lovely common to the coconut ice. Not coconut ice, coconut krill. Here we go. Lovely. Right. Let's get it back.
I don't know. It's one of those things that you avoid fishing in the rain. Well, I avoid fishing in the rain. I know it's like, if it rains while you're fishing, never mind. But to set up in the rain like it did yesterday, I wouldn't normally do that. And, it's actually paying off. It's paying off quite well, actually. I've had 7 fish. I'm working out now. 3 doubles of... no. I've had 3 single-figure fish, I think. 2 nines and now the one-eyed 7. 2 doubles, an 11 and a 12. And a 21 and a 20. That's obscene for me. I never usually do that. I don't know. I usually come on blank. That's my standard. I don't... Has something happened that I haven't realised? I don't know. Alright then, I'll catch you later. So hopefully the rain will stop by then. Right. For the first time ever, I've had a triple run. Middle rod screamed off. I picked it up. And then the right hand rod screamed off as I was playing the fish. The lines got absolutely tangled together. I tried to pull one out of the way. There's nothing I could do. The right hand rod buried straight into the lilies. Eventually, when I got this one into the net, the lines was just tangled together in a mess. So I've tried to hand line the other one in. It was tight, it was like locked into the weeds, and eventually that came off. Literally as I'm retrieving the rig and everything by hand, the left hand rod screams off and I got a nice mid double common by the looks of it in the net. So I've got a mirror and a common in the net, so I'll see if I can get them both up and get a double photo. If they just won't behave, then it'll be one at a time. Right
then, so I've quickly weighed them. Pair of nice fish again. This one, the mirror, was £13.04. Give them a quick flip around. Here we go. And cover that up. And down. And a common. Oh, second time round was £21.4. I think it was £21 something, yeah, earlier last night. But, yeah. Let's get them back.
Right, so that's dealt with, and it's got dark really quick. Probably because I was busy and I didn't realise it was happening. Yeah, so triple run. I only managed two of the fish, so I suppose another brace, really. But yeah, it was pretty good. It was nice to see that the same £20 common, £21 common again. I don't think I'll count it as it's not another 20. It is the same fish, and it's within 24 hours, so I don't think that really counts. If it was sort of like months down the line, maybe a couple of years, or maybe at a different weight, I suppose, then I would say yeah, it's a count as another capture, but no, not within 24 hours, I don't think. But it's still nice to see it though, and well, it's all dealt with, gone back, and I've got one rod just to rebait. Check the rig. One's one tangled because it's a total mess, and the knot is lined. And the other one, I've got to re-rig completely. Brilliant. All right then, I'll see you later. Right then. So it's night time. I've dealt with those three rods. I got them back out. I really am not prepared at all. Just like most of the time, really. I had to tie a rig from scratch. I went through what I had in the bag, and I just thought that none of them fitted the job, really. So I retied another rig, which is great, because I was doing like all the bending of the tubing and everything like that over the kettle, but I've forgotten my sugar, so I couldn't make myself a cup of coffee, proper coffee anyway. It'd just be plain black. Can't do that. But yeah, so I know that next time I come, or anywhere I go, I need to get myself a bit prepared. I need to have some rigs tied. I need to just get things prepared. I'm just total shambles and a mess when I go fishing. Most of the time I'm going through boxes and there's like things to snag your fingers on, and I don't know, I'm just a mess. But it's not been too bad, and it's probably the most successful session I've ever had. Technically, I've caught 3 £20 fish in this session, even though one was a recapture. It's just still banking a 20. I don't know. I'm still really in two minds whether to count it or not. But, yeah, I suppose, I don't know, see what happens. Right. I've got to be up early tomorrow because I've got to get everything packed down, and if it carries on raining, it's going to be an absolute nightmare. So I'm going to see if I can get a bit of sleep. Hopefully again, I'll get a couple of runs during the night. I'm not counting on it, really. I sort of had the flurry of runs last night and right up until this morning, and then I stopped baiting with the sort of fruit bomb because I'd run out of it, and I started baiting with the change of baits sort of killed it for a bit, and then I had three runs at once, so can't really say that killed it. Or perhaps I'm going to have a chaos moment in the middle of the night or something like that. I don't know. But what I do know, I'm going to try and get some sleep now. I've had hot dogs for tea. I haven't run you through what I've been eating,
because it's, apart from the bacon sandwich, I think, because it's just, I don't know. Well, I had, what did I have? I had pasta and meatballs yesterday evening, and I had hot dogs for tea, bacon, and two bacon sandwiches today, actually. But, yeah, I haven't eaten a lot, really. We're living off energy drinks, but, yeah, I'll do some more bacon in the morning, and I'll see if I get a fish. Alright then, I'll speak to you later, hopefully. Ta-da. Right there, so, I don't know, I bumped off about 3 fish in the early hours, and then about 6 o'clock now, and I just put this little mirror in the net. So, and up and away, I mean, probably about 4 or 5 pounds. He's still a bit lively. So, I don't know, I'm not sure what the tally is, but this is the first fish of the second morning. Little mirror. Yeah, there's a few fish crashing out there, so let's get him back and get the bait back out, is it? Again, well, about 5 minutes later, and I got another little dirty one. I probably wouldn't give this, I'd give him about £3, but well, they were right next to each other. They were sort of like within, well, 5 minutes of each other. But I'm not going to make too much fuss with this one. It's still a nice little dark fish. Let's get it back. So, the heavy baiting I was doing yesterday is actually starting to pay off this morning. All 3 rods are out of the water now. I can't get this one to stay calm, but another mirror, a little bit bigger. I haven't weighed him. I'm going to go about 7 or 8 again. He won't calm down. But, another lovely little fish. This is the 3rd fish in a row now. This is mad, this is. At least they're not all coming at the same time like they did last night. So there's a rough fish on every rod. Mad. I have to get them out and hopefully get a few more. Right then, let's get it back. Right. Literally, this has only been out for, I don't know, a matter of minutes. I've just got the 3 rods sorted. And this one screams off again, in the lilies. It's weighing in at 12 pounds 1 ounces. It's another cracking common carp. Here we go. Fins up. Nope, no fins up. Yeah, they're getting bigger. But what is this? I don't know, it's my like 4th double or 3rd double. Slipping around. It's almost scale perfect both sides. But like with every spring rock fish, a spring water fish, they don't stop fighting until you put them back. There we go. 12 pound one, pristine little common. I don't have to stamp around either. Right, let's get this one back. Right then. So, we just started packing up, and the middle rod screams off again. Can I get this little? Ooh, little feisty one. The scales on that for a little mirror. Lovely little fish. It's pretty much the same sort of scale pattern on the other side. But he's not behaving. Oh, come on. There we go. Lovely little scales, isn't it? Right. Let's get him back and carry on packing up. Here we go. I think this is fish number 15, I think it is. Another pretty little mirror. But, yeah, on the same spot, tight up against the island. I actually put a coconut ice on. So, seems like they'll take anything at the moment. But, yeah. Not too much fuss, let's get it back. See behind me, the rods are out, the baby's down, everything's packed away, and that sort of concludes my two nights at Springwater Lakes. I was hoping for a bit of a session like last year, where I had 17 fish and a PB common at that time. I think it was 16-10, I think, at the time. I really didn't expect sort of get a 20-pound grass carp and then top it off with a 20-pound common again, so that two new PBs. Straight off in the first night, and then to see the common again on the second night. That was great, but it's one of these sessions, I think probably one of the best sessions I've ever had, really. It is one of the best sessions I've ever had. So I'm on my way home now. I didn't quite hit the 17 fish total I was going for. I got to 15, so it's not too bad, is it? I don't know. It's not many times I can use the word fantastic without being sarcastic, really, but I can think that this was a fantastic session, really. Check out the website for Springwater Lakes. The address will be up there. And I'll see you next time I'm on the bank. Enjoy the photos. Alright, ta-da.